There are five basic types of hybrid orbitals: sp, sp2, sp3, sp3d, and sp3d2. Let's look at these orbitals one at a time. The sp hybrid orbital is a combination of 1s and 1p orbital. An example of a molecule with sp hybridization is beryllium fluoride, which has this Lewis structure. Beryllium fluoride has linear geometry. The three atoms, two fluorine atoms and a beryllium atom, lie in a straight line. The central beryllium atom has two valence orbitals pointing in opposite directions towards the fluorine atoms. The direction of the valence orbitals is dictated by the hybridization of the atomic orbitals. Let's see how this is done in beryllium fluoride. If we hybridize the 2s orbital with the 2px orbital in a beryllium atom, the result is a set of two sp hybrid orbitals. The number of hybrid orbitals is always the same as the total number of contributing atomic orbitals. These two sp orbitals point in exactly opposite directions. Now we're ready to make a molecule of beryllium fluoride. We need a beryllium atom with sp hybridization of its valence orbitals and two fluorine atoms, each with one electron in a p atomic orbital. The p orbital from each fluorine atom overlaps with an sp hybrid orbital in the beryllium atom. This is how the three atoms of beryllium fluoride, a linear molecule, are arranged, with beryllium at the center. The sp2 hybrid orbital is a combination of 1s and 2p orbitals. An example of a molecule with sp2 hybridization is boron trifluoride. Boron trifluoride has trigonal planar geometry. The three fluorine atoms in the molecule form a triangular shape, with the boron atom at the center of this triangle. The boron atom has three orbitals oriented outwards at 120 degrees to each other. Let's see what sp2 hybrid orbitals look like. We'll use an s orbital, a px orbital, and a py orbital to make the sp2 hybrid orbitals. There are three hybrid orbitals, the same as the number of contributing orbitals. These three sp2 orbitals, when viewed from above, look like a leaf with three lobes. To make the boron trifluoride molecule, we'll view the process from above the plane of the atoms to see better what happens. We already have a boron atom with three sp2 hybrid orbitals. Now we need three fluorine atoms. A p electron from each fluorine atom pairs up with an electron in an sp2 hybrid orbital in a boron atom. Now the four atoms of the molecule boron trifluoride are in one plane. The sp3 hybrid orbital is a combination of 1s and all three p orbitals. A molecule with sp3 hybridization is methane. There are five atoms in methane, one carbon atom, and four hydrogen atoms. Methane has tetrahedral geometry at the carbon atom. The four hydrogens around the carbon atom make a tetrahedron, with the carbon atom at the center. Each carbon atom has four orbitals oriented outwards at 109.5 degrees to each other. Now let's hybridize the s orbital with a px orbital, a py orbital, and a pz orbital. We get four sp3 hybrid orbitals, the same as the number of contributing orbitals. These four sp3 orbitals together form a tetrahedron. To make the methane molecule, we will use the carbon atom with four sp3 hybrid orbitals and four hydrogen atoms, each with a 1s orbital. The s electron from each hydrogen atom pairs up with the electron in an sp3 hybrid orbital in a carbon atom. The result is a molecule of methane. The sp3d hybrid orbital is a combination of 1s, all 3p orbitals, and a d orbital. The phosphorus atom in phosphorus pentachloride is an example of an atom with sp3d hybridization. Phosphorus pentachloride has trigonal bipyramidal geometry. The five chlorine atoms around the phosphorus atom make a shape like two triangular pyramids joined together at their bases. There are five hybrid orbitals, the same as the number of contributing orbitals. The sp3d2 hybrid orbital is a combination of 1s, all 3p orbitals, and 2d orbitals. One example of a molecule with sp3d2 hybridization is sulfur hexafluoride. Sulfur hexafluoride has octahedral geometry. The sp3d2 hybrid orbitals of the sulfur atom make a shape like two square pyramids joined at their square bases.